Welcome to Dr. Tom Talks. Today, a special on cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, or CVST, that you may have heard about recently in the news. I'm going to be talking about the condition itself, what is it, and also the symptoms associated with it that I think everyone should be aware of. So with the help of the BioDigital Human, I'm going to do just that. Here is the brain, obviously. This is where this condition occurs, and this is the venous system. And specifically, I've stripped away the skull here to show you these venous sinuses, which is where this condition occurs. So this is the back of the brain, this is the superior sagittal sinus, and this is the transverse sinus. And they're these big vein-like structures that take blood back from the brain to the heart so that the heart can then send it to the lungs, oxygenate the blood, and then send it back out to the body via the arterial system. So what happens inside these venous sinuses? Well, if we zoom into one of them, here's a venous sinus right here. What happens is a blood clot occurs. And so cerebral, meaning brain, venous sinus, meaning this vein-like structure, thrombosis, that's just a fancy word for a blood clot. And what happens when you get a blood clot in one of these venous sinuses is the blood itself can actually spill out. It can't get past this back to go back to the heart, and it can spill out. And in so doing, if we go back to the brain, it can cause a stroke. So here we have the brain. This is the front of the head. This is the back of the head. And you'll see here, this is one of the venous sinuses. So using the draw tool here, I'm going to use a red color to represent blood. If you have a big blood clot in here, that can actually cause that blood to spill out, causing a hemorrhage. And then you get this area representing here. This is representing a stroke. So various areas of your brain can be affected. So it's really important to understand then the symptoms of a stroke so that you can help yourself or other people. So it's great to start with a mnemonic called FAST. F standing for facial drooping or any changes with your face in that respect. A for arm weakness. So if you're weak in potentially one arm, but it can be weakness really anywhere in the body. S stands for speech, if it's difficult to understand someone or you yourself are finding it difficult to speak. And T is time to call 911. Time really is of the essence with a stroke. There can be other symptoms, of course, like headache, blurred vision, any changes in consciousness, and any fainting and so on, and really any loss of control of any part of the body. This was a Dr. Tom special on cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, or CVST. For any more information, please do go to biodigital.com. If you're in any way concerned that someone you know may be having a stroke, it's really important to call 911 and take them to the emergency room.